the different kinds of tumors that occur in the brain, we break it down into tumors that are within the substance of the brain versus those that are outside the brain pushing on the brain. The diagnosis, the type of tumor, has different implications based on its growth potential, based on the natural history of how the tumor might change, either with treatment or without treatment. And the care for an individual person is very much dictated by the diagnosis. Again, the diagnosis is established usually with an operation, although there are certain tumors that are very characteristic on MRI imaging, and the diagnosis is almost assured on the imaging itself, such that an operation might not be necessary when it's first picked up. The intrinsic lesions in the brain, and those are tumors that grow from the substance of the brain, they grow from a cell that's normally in the brain, those are tumors that have the most implications. Those are usually the tumors that need the quickest care. They come in slow-growing or faster-growing versions. They're also called low-grade or high-grade. There's our different classification schemes that mean the same thing. They're called astrocytoma, anaplastic astrocytoma, or glioblastoma multiforme. They also go by numbers 2, 3, and 4. It can be difficult to tell on an MRI scan exactly which diagnosis somebody might have. I think it can be somewhat anxiety-provoking to search out too much information about diagnosis until you've sat down with either your surgeon or your healthcare provider to have them explain some of the nuances of the MRI scan, the likelihood of different diagnoses. Ultimately, a procedure is needed to get tissue to establish that diagnosis, and then the path that someone's going to be on, what they can expect to happen, the types of treatment that they will have, and how this might impact their life can be well described for the person.